Good morning everyone, welcome to the morning tales for May 2019. And for the previous video, previous morning tales, the answer is correct. Mulshi Dam is located in Maharashtra. So for May 8, 2019, we'll be talking about the new Japanese satellite, the comic series which has been released recently, the famous squash player, the report which has been released. So let's start with what is the name of series of ISRO's, that is the Indian Space Research Organization. First all-weather observation satellite. So ISRO is all set to launch its RISAT-BR1. So it's 2BR1 satellite, RISAT-2BR1 satellite, which is all set to launch on May 22nd. So this mission was expected to be launched next year, but now they have preponed this and they'll be launching this on May 22nd. Now coming to this satellite, what is this satellite and what are the new features of this satellite? So this is basically a remote sensing satellite which will be providing all weather surveillance using the synthetic aperture radars. And it's a first all weather observation satellite from ISRO. So these satellite would be providing the continuous view of Earth either at day or at night for the forces, basically for the forces to detect the border infiltration. Earlier what used to happen, the satellite's view was objected or was blocked by, handicapped by the clouds which are there in the sky. Therefore, to avoid that situation, ISRO is going to launch its first all-weather observation satellite. Moving to the next important question, which organization is aiming to establish database? So the name of the database, so question might come for the name of the database as well. That Global Registry of War and Deaths, it's a database. Which organization is going to establish this? So the organization which is going to establish is SIPRI. Now I'm not going to tell you about the full form of SIPRI as in the previous video where we already discussed about the SIPRI's report on India's weapons. So comment your answer that what is the full form of SIPRI. Now coming to this database which is known as the Global Registry of War and Deaths. So this database is a new initiative where they'll be calculating or where they'll be putting the annual number of war and deaths worldwide. So it's not restricted to some countries, but it's going to provide the data regarding the annual number of violent deaths. Now it is going to be the open source database where eventually the researchers, the policy makers and the general public would be able to track the trends in the violence at the global or the regional or the national levels as well. One more thing which is important in this question is it is streamlined on the basis of the Sustainable Development Goal number 16. And what is the Sustainable Development Goal number 16? So basically to reduce all forms of violence and related deaths everywhere by 2030. This is the SDG 16 where they wish to reduce the number of violent deaths by 2030. What you need to mention in the comment section below, the full form of SIPRI, what does SIPRI stand for? Next question is, and it's a one of a kind initiative which has been taken. So Zero Pendency Codes project has been launched in. It's a pilot project first of all. Remember this thing, it's a pilot project. And which court, High Court has actually decided to implement this Zero Pendency Codes project. So it has been implemented by Delhi High Court. Also there was this news that the Delhi's High Court is requiring 43 more judges to basically clear all the pending cases in 1 year. And what is the current number? So the current number is 143 and they need 43 more judges to clear all the cases in 1 year. Now this Zero Pendency Codes project, as the name suggests, it's one of a kind project in India and is aimed to study the life cycle of cases to come up with optimal timeline for all the cases. Now, why is it important to resolve the cases on a timely manner? What is the need of that? Now, if we look at the data in GDP numbers, so it was estimated that the judicial delays cost India approximately 1.5% of the GDP, which is a very huge number. And this is the annual rate. The delay in the judicial cases is costing around 1.5% of the GDP. Therefore, the Zero Pendency Courts project, the pilot project, was implemented in Delhi High Court to fast track the judicial cases. Very important question and might come in the examination. Another and very interesting question is that this is for the first time that Japan has privately built its rocket and it has been sent to space recently. Now, what is the name of the Japan's first privately built rocket? You might think the answer is Momo 1, but earlier Japan has failed in two projects, the Momo 1 and Momo 2. Now they have successfully implemented this Momo 3 project and the rocket has been sent to space recently. So Momo 3 is the answer of this question, that Japan's first privately built rocket. And what is the name of the company which has launched this satellite? So it's Interstellar Technology Inc. That is the name of the company which has launched this Momo 3. Nothing much to remember, but it's Japan's first privately built rocket, Momo 3. Although the official name has been not given, but it's known famously by Momo 3. Moving on to the next question, Striker 47, very famous series. So this is for the first time that Cristiano Ronaldo has created it, his own series, the comic series. Also, this is the comic book and a series as well. This cartoon would be depicting that Ronaldo has transformed into a superhero, doing a battle with the other animated characters, maybe robots or aliens. So he has transformed into a superhero. So Cristiano Ronaldo, the series is based on the famous football player, striker 47, Cristiano Ronaldo. Very important question. So Saurav Ghoshal is associated with which sport? I think I have already asked or discussed about this person in the previous news. But the main thing which is required to remember regarding Saurav Ghoshal is that he has become the first Indian male squash player to enter the top 10 in the latest PSA rankings, which has been released. So the first Indian male squash player. So with which sport he is associated? That is squash. And not only this, as we were aware about the Asian Squash Championship, he has won the individual title as well. So for the male title, male individual title, Saurav Ghoshal has won. And for the women individual title, Joshna Chinnappa, she has won the title. Very, very important question. Joshna Chinnappa and Saurav Ghoshal, they are associated with squash. And they have also won the individual title at the Asian Squash Championship. Now the question for you is that where was this Asian Squash Championship held? What was the venue of this Asian Squash Championship? Mention your answer in the comment section and remember that these two are the most important or famous player in the squash. Now I have come up with two questions for you for which I'm not going to tell the answer. The first official brand ambassador of Myntra, I have put the picture over here as well, if you can guess the picture. So first official brand ambassador of Myntra, you need to mention your answer in the comment section. I don't think even the hint is required for this. You might have come across the advertisement which is shown on the television as well. So it might be the easiest question among these questions that the first official brand ambassador of Myntra is. Mention that in the comment section. And moving on to the last question, the Chinar Wildlife Sanctuary is located in. And for this question, I'm going to provide you hint. So I'm going to tell you about the national parks which are there in the state. So the very famous national park is the Silent Valley National Park. Very, very famous national park. And another very famous national park is the Periyar National Park. Now it's almost the easiest question or the easiest answer to guess that where is the Chinar Wildlife Sanctuary located. So mention your answer in the comment section below and do not forget to subscribe to our channel if you have learned anything from this video. Also, if you haven't watched the previous videos of Morning Tales, do watch those videos as we have covered the important current affairs regarding the different dates. Thank you so much for watching the video.